Hey there, welcome to Wait a Minute, my videos, my thoughts, and I'm sharing them with you. My name is Wade, and hang on for the ride. So, yesterday, I tell you guys the weirdest things. Yesterday, I took my phone and started, you know, finagling around so I could take a picture of me from all sides. And, why didn't y'all tell me how funny I look? Nah, just kidding. I'm not kidding, but I'm just kidding. I found out for sure. I confirmed a few things. I confirmed I have no butt. That's just not going to happen. I have no butt. And that there is... there's other things about me. I have less hair than I thought I did. And I knew I had... My hair was thinning, but I didn't realize that there's actually spots where there's no hair. But y'all people are either really mean for not telling me, or you're really nice for not telling me. I don't know. But I got, you know, different angles of myself, and I've been experimenting with the whole with the video in my room instead of in the car, so I can see more of me and all that stuff. And I just, different angles of me, plus when I get up to turn off the camera, I see a different angle of me than I normally see, like stooping over or whatever, and I'm like, wow, maybe there's things about me I shouldn't know, but, you know, it's been a really eye-opening experience, and I will take you somewhere dealing with this one thing. Sorry about that, I had to pause you there, just so you know that was intentional, that little glitch that just happened. As it turns out, when you leave the house and you're going to get the mail, you should have the key to the mailbox if you have a locked mailbox. So, it occurred to me that I should probably come back. So I did. Nah. Anyways, looking at myself, is a hard thing for me to do because I've never been proud of myself. I've never been sure of myself when it comes to my looks or anything like that. And then I was also very insecure and very beat down by bullies and such things when I was younger, and that kind of hangs over for a long time. In fact, I understand if it's hanging over on you guys, because it's been hanging over on me for a lot of years. I was probably 50 when I really started noticing my security in myself and my love for myself. Probably about 50, or maybe in my 40s, but I think it was in my right around 50. Anyway, whatever. It took a long time for me to get there. I don't think it has to take you that long. I think what happens is it's based on, you know, your insecurity and whether or not you're seeking help and all that kind of stuff. I don't know where mine actually came from. I know in later times, like 2 years ago, it came with getting my heart fixed and not having, you know, not dying from lung disease anymore, and I lost a bunch of weight, and I think all that kind of helps. But, you know, looking at myself in the camera lens and seeing what I look like all the way around, yeah, I'm still sure of myself. I mean, I'm still confident, but it isn't really anything in me. It's just I love myself, and I want to look as good as I can, but you know what? I can't help some things. You know, I'll probably never have a butt, you know, which really sucks. I'm going to get letters for that. I may never have, you know, six-pack abs or anything like that. But you know what? I lost a little over 60 pounds so far. That's a lot of weight. Have you picked up a 60-pound bag of anything ever? I mean, like, wow, that's a lot. And I just noticed that recently, how much that really is. I'm going to pause you. Oh, shit. Moving right along. That's the last pause I'm going to do, I swear. Anyways, got something cool in the mail today, so it was worth it. I don't know if you guys like rings, but I love rings, and it made me feel better about myself. I don't know if you can see this, but that's what it is. And I love it. Yay. Fits me perfect, right where I wanted it to be. I've always been a ring person, and I guess I'll be a ring person when I die. But just so you know, all you people that want a little piece, after I die, there's like, I don't know, there's probably close to 200 rings now, because I just got new ones. I get obsessive about certain things. Rings, coats, shoes, you know, I'm big on those things. But anyways, let's move along, Wade. Okay, let's do that. Both of us think that we should move on. I looked at myself and I saw some things I didn't like and a lot of things I did. And kind of cool, you know? I mean, like, I still got weight to lose, so there's places where, like, oh yeah, I need to work on that. And then there's places that I'm doing good on. I'm like, oh great, that's awesome. And then other places where I just really didn't care because it wasn't really that important and I want to focus on the important things. You know what I mean? So I checked myself out and I still believe in myself. I still have confidence and I, you know, I look as good as I can. You know, that's just, I do my best, you know. As this pastor used to say, it was an issue about makeup, whether women should wear makeup or not. And he said, well, you know what? If the barn needs painting, paint it. So in another way, I don't wear makeup, but, you know, if the barn needs painting, paint it. All about me. Okay, so enough about me. Let's go on to you. So I thought about that as I was, you know, just checking myself out and seeing how I was doing and as far as physical and, you know, mental, emotional, whatever, growth. And I like me and I'm happy with me and it's a really cool feeling. Anyway, I said that to say this. I think all of us need to, number one, for our personal selves, look at ourselves and see where we need work, you know. So, you know, if you want to feel better about yourself, a lot of times, you know, just do stuff to care for yourself. I mean, it's not evil to want to look good. It's not evil to try to do your very best to be healthy. I'm healthier now than I've been in 30 years, at least 30 years. And that makes me happy, you know? So anyway, said all that. Now let's say this. As far as being a good person, okay? Now this is for Christians and non-Christians alike. Christians, apply it to yourself and your Christian walk. But here's the deal. You don't have to be floating along, hiding from, and looking away from the things that are wrong with you, you know? Do the thing. I mean, you know, look at yourself. You know, are you kind? Are you, you know, do you need exercise? Do you need to eat right? All of those things. When you look at yourself, do you see that there's some places really need work? Some places, you know, you tried to do something and you failed, so you stopped. And those kind of things. You know, anything that was physical that I just said can totally be a spiritual thing and a growth thing for your person, your personality, your character, all that. So look at yourself. And if you see a place where you need to be more like Jesus, be more like Jesus. And for those who are not Christians, if you see a place that you need to be more like, have more integrity or more, you know, like more honest, more kind, more any of those things. If you need that, then do it. You know, I mean, it's harder for some people than others. I get that. When I was a kid, my lips were moving, I was lying. I lied a lot. And I was pretty good at it, but my mom usually knew. There's a couple times she didn't, and she didn't find out till a few years ago, and she was really mad. But most of the time, people just look at themselves from just a far off distance. They don't really look at the things that are wrong. They don't want to focus on those things. But you've got to focus on those things before you can fix them. And there's nothing wrong with, I mean, don't be down on yourself. If you got places that need to be fixed, fix it. There's no shame. The shame would be to have those things in your life and to never fix them. And as a Christian, the shame of the thing would be to never be able to reach people for Jesus, never be able to set a good example, and maybe never even know Jesus, which is the worst thing. A lot of Christians are not Christians. And I'm not judging any one of them because I don't know. It's between them and God. They and God know. So, you know, check yourself. It's really important. Look at yourself in a spiritual eye. You know, hold that camera all over you. Look all different ways. And don't skip the butt because you need to know. Just saying. Don't skip up here because you need to know. Anyways, I love you guys. I'm not trying to condemn anybody for anything. And if you feel that way, sorry about that. I'm not fat shaming. I'm not sin shaming. None of that. This is just me, something that I came up with this morning, something I was thinking about. Right up until I started the video, I didn't have any idea where it was going to go. But I looked at myself, and there's places that need work. And I think if you look at yourself, you'll see places that need work. So let's do this thing. You know, the world will be a better place if we can make ourselves better and help other people to be better. So, love you guys. Good luck. God bless. And I hope you stay safe and happy and healthy.